Hello and welcome to the Hidden Village of Art. I'm Higimura and today we're going to be doing an unboxing and first impressions. So today we're going to be doing, as I said earlier, an unboxing and first impressions. And of course, being that Christmas has passed, New Year's has already begun. Happy New Year to all my fellow shadow artists in the new 2017, by the way. Today, I'm gonna be unboxing unboxing might be a bit much. Probably an unbagging would probably be more correctly. I will ensure all my fellow shadow artists that upon receipt, it did come in a box, but it was more like a shipping box. It didn't have any special like box with like the name of the company or anything on it. So this is what you get actually in the mail. Now, what might you say this is? Well, this is a Revolve 2-in-1 tripod and monopod. So this unboxing will be perfect for all you video type shadow artists or would-be photographer shadow artists or those who are pro or semi-pro. So let's go ahead and open this up. Now, the first thing that I notice is that it comes in a really nice padded bag. Very well designed, seems to have a more plastic cover on the bottom to protect it from the weather. Very well padded, I'd say about maybe half a centimeter or a little less than half an inch of padding. It's really nice, okay. And we have our lovely tripod here. Okay, so the first thing we get is that we get an Allen key. I'm guessing that one of the things in this tripod is that we're going to use that. And it comes with a nice Velcro belt. This would be used for holding your ID or any type of small items that you would need for your camera on the go. It's really nice and has like a little pocket there right built in, which is really very cool. And it comes with a clip, kind of like one of those veneers on it. I'm not too sure if you can see that. Okay, that's quite nice. Sorry, let's just sit that in our bag. Okay, so it's quite compact. Upon initial impression, it looks really nice. Nice black and teal blue. You can see that they've taken their time to make sure that this was properly taken care of. Now, let's see here. Now, from what I've gauged from the website, which I will leave in the link in this description below, it's supposed to allow you to do a number of different types of angles. So this is actually pretty cool. The legs are nice and stiff. I don't know if that's because it's just opened and, you know, I haven't given it a ride or anything like that. It does have this pouch to protect the top ball bearings, which I think is rather nice. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead, and also that is padded too. Very nicely padded, so about the same padding as the original box, about half an inch or so. Yeah, that's rather nice. Okay, it's good. Make sure all your stuff is taken care of. Now, this does come with a leveler, which is really good for whenever you're on site and you need to make sure that your camera's there. Now, it does say that it can go as high as 62 inches, which it should be as tall as me. Very nice, and it locks in quite easily. It comes with these little push buttons that you can open up and push down, and it's quite strong. Bit greased up, but you know, it's quite new. So let's see if this baby can actually stand up to 62 inches, which would be the same height as me. So upon releasing all the locks, which took a little bit more than maybe a minute or so, as you can see, it's not a full 62 inches, but if I brought in the legs a bit more, I guess I would make it just shy shorter than me. So I'm 5'2". Okay, and this is supposed to be stretched out to 62 inches, so that's actually not that bad. It's really good. One thing that I can tell you is that it's quite light. Like, you can almost forget how light it is despite the structure. So it's pretty sturdy, has a nice, you know, free ball bearing here where you can move it around easily. It has a leveler both on the side and over on the top, and it gives a really good impression of real good quality. Now here's something you probably don't know, which I mentioned earlier. This leg, this blue labeled leg, is actually the leg that you would be using for creating your monopod. So that's actually pretty nice. You can go ahead, walk around with a lovely tripod, and if you need to use a monopod, it's just right there for you to use. And very easy to lock back in place. You simply screw the leg back in. So it's actually quite nice. I'm very surprised at the quality of the tripod that I've received. Okay, let's go ahead and weigh this baby out. Okay, so we are coming about to almost 2 kilograms here. Now this tripod is really quite professional, as I mentioned earlier. It's really nice, it's very well compact, very easy to travel with. It comes with a padded bag, which makes it easier to travel with. So I doubt you would have any trouble with like airlines or anything like that regarding this item. I do recommend it. It's really great. I really love it. I'll be using it from now on in my future videos. So look forward to nice new stable looks or anything with my with the monopod that this baby comes with. So yes, the Revolve tripod monopod is really the way to go for anyone who's doing any travel work regarding photography or videos, or even if you're just a startup YouTuber. And for those who are wondering about price, this is set to $89.99 United States dollars. So in total, it actually came up to about $100 or so with shipping and handling. If you're within the United States, you have a great, awesome deal with having the free shipping done within the States. So that's great. Unfortunately, anyone like myself who lives in Australia, you're gonna have to pay shipping for. Well, that's all for the unbagging today. This is definitely, as I said, an amazing item. I highly recommend it. So you guys, here's the question of the day. Have you ever used this type of item, the Revolve tripod, monopod, or even similar brands? Let me know in the comments below. And also, I have a quick announcement. On this weekend, January 6th, 7th and 8th, I'll be at a convention called Convergence, which will be at the Amora Riverside Hotel. I'll have a link down in the description. If you're interested in just coming by, or if you're a fellow convention goer, just let me know in the comments below and say hello. I'll be over in the dealer's room, table 36, right near the dealer's room entrance, and you can easily find me with my red bandana, my awesome new uniform. So yeah, let's take this out. If you enjoyed this video, brush that like button. Want to see more? Hit that subscribe button. Want to be in the know and share ideas? Then join our Facebook page at the Hidden Village of Art. And in the words of my ancestors, shadow artists vanish.